Hello, beautiful people. LosingDrea here. Today it is Wednesday. It is January 25th, 2017, and I believe this is day 18 of my trying keto. So yesterday I had a little bit of a rough patch. Okay, guys, I'm going to be totally transparent with you, as I am always on my channel. If I'm not honest with you, who can I be honest with? And I'm not being honest with myself. Hopefully you're picking this up. I do have a little microphone here. If you're picking it up too loudly, my apologies. However, I want to make sure that you can hear me, and I have my camera set back a lot further than I normally do, because as you can see, I'm doing a bit of a keto breakfast mukbang. Now, I'm not really sure yet what I should be eating on a ketogenic diet. Phase one. I say phase one because beginning, start. All I know from what I've been researching and reading is that the lower you keep your carbs, recommended no more than 20 grams a day, the quicker you go into ketosis. And I can tell you that after the first couple of days, I wasn't hungry, I was feeling energy, and I had no problem with not even trying to do it intermittent fasting, but I was just eating twice a day because I really wasn't hungry. However, that being said, you know, I was eating pretty much hamburgers, cheese, yada, yada, this, that, and the other thing, and not really knowing, like I said, what am I doing here? And I'm trying to count calories and not count calories because, you know, I looked at Dr. Eric Westman's video about starting on a ketogenic diet from his research studies or clinical research study, where he mentions his page four, that if it's not on page four, don't eat it. And so, I'm having coffee. It's not bulletproof coffee, guys, but it does have heavy cream in it and a little bit of stevia. Inside the, it's funny, it looks like it has butter in here. Inside the little container of heavy cream that I bought was a thick coating around the inside of basically butter. I don't know if somebody shook the cream or it just turned that way. It was not curdled milk. It did not taste sour. It didn't smell sour, so I scraped the inside of that and I put it in my coffee, and I might have inadvertently created bulletproof coffee. I don't know if you guys can see it, but there are, like, you know, like what happens when you put butter or oil into your coffee and you get these little like an oil slick, you know, like those kind of little bubbles that come to the surface. Tastes pretty good, guys. A little bit of great value liquid stevia and the coffee and whatever was left in the thing of the actual liquid of the whipping cream, heavy whipping cream, and then that stuff. What I have here is 4 eggs, 5 slices of bacon, and 1 85-gram serving of spinach. And this is cooking spinach. You buy it in the bag at Great Value, Walmart, whatever. And it was 85 grams weighed before cooking. Don't know if that matters or not. And to that and the eggs, I have put pink Himalayan salt. So I pretty much wanted to come on here and do a little bit of a mukbang. It's been a while since I did one. Just talk to you all. And, you know, last night I had a little bit of dark chocolate. I know they say you can have dark chocolate, but I really don't know what kind of dark chocolate you can have. And again, that is not something that was on Dr. Westman's page four that I can recall. However, hubby broke into this bar that was in there forever, and as long as it wasn't open and I wasn't touching, he opened it. I got into it. And I was able to break off 2 little chunks, 2 more little chunks broke off. So I had maybe more than I was supposed to have. I don't know. A little while later, those nasty, I'm going to just say it as plain English as I can, those nasty ass gelatin, sugar-free gelatin, Jif, whatever they're called, gelatins, were in the refrigerator, and I basically took one, then I took another, then I took a third, and each one of those I put whipped cream into them, and then had whipped cream on top of it. So, yeah, I had quite a bit, and each one of those servings of whipped cream does have a gram or 2 of sugar, and a carb in it. So, you know, it is what it is. But I overate on other things. Sorry about that. Because I ate a burger and a half with, these are farm eggs right from the chicken, guys. I haven't tried these yet. My mom, I made her breakfast too. She said it was delicious. Tastes just like eggs, so I don't know. I guess that's what happens. But these came right from a farm, real fresh. Haven't been to a store. Wow. Weren't washed, whatever. They don't, like, wash them because if you wash an egg, the cold water will make it expand. If you do need to wash it for any reason, you're supposed to wash them in warm water so that it doesn't shrink or expand inside. But they literally have been out on the counter, and you're supposed to keep them out on the counter, and they can keep for up to a month on the counter, not being refrigerated. And that is a real egg that has been untouched by machinery or human hands, or, well, I guess maybe some human hands picked it out of the chicken coop. But in any case, God, they really are delicious. I think I can taste the difference, but I'm just enjoying them. So, yeah, you know, all this stuff I'm eating yesterday, but besides what I ate, it didn't seem to affect my weight any. I actually came down a little bit on the scale, or I stayed the same. I think I stayed the same. Yeah, yesterday I was 256.8. Today I'm about 256.8. So the scale didn't move, and I think I ate like a whole bunch, but I was constantly hungry. And if you're hungry, then that means that you are, I don't know, I guess you're lacking something in your diet, or, you know, you didn't eat enough fat. So, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to put my spinach in my yolk and have some of my yolk on my spinach. For some reason, that to me sounds like it would taste delicious, and I'm pretty sure I'm right. Yeah. So what I do know is to eat greens with every meal, because the fiber that's in the greens is going to counteract any carbs, so that my net carbs are whatever the total carbs minus my fiber, that's my net carbs. And that's what I need to be watching, net carbs. Okay. So that being said, I know that much. So I just recently, like this morning, downloaded an app onto my phone. I can't tell you exactly what it is at the moment because I'm actually recording this on my phone. I find it the best and quickest way to get my videos out to you guys without making a million excuses for why they didn't make it to you on time. But that app, I hope, because I didn't get the chance to look at all of it, I hope will give me more of like menu selections. You know, I want to find some key foods that I'm okay with eating breakfast, lunch, and dinner on a daily basis every day without having to get too complicated or difficult, and just stick to that. That's what I want to do. I can do that. I could eat the same food every day, and it'll be a while, I'm pretty sure, before I start getting bored and or wanting something else. But I need to get myself back into that mode that I was in that first few days, because I never felt better in those first few days. You know, I'm constantly tired now. I'm probably not getting enough fat. I was never one to want to, like, measure. I mean, I like grabbing a processed slice of turkey breast because I know it's 35 calories. I like, you know, when you have a, you know, when you're eating bread or something, you have one of those Joseph's low carb wraps or something, you know, like that 60 calories, you know, everything I knew, it was processed and it was previously portioned out and weighed for me, making it easier for me to log it when it came to logging it into MyFitnessPal or Spark People, whatever I was using. Because if you know me, you know, I've used both. I'm back to MyFitnessPal only because counting macros. And as it seems, it's really not making a difference, because in order for me to get the proper, grid or the the pie that shows the proper macros. You have to pay for the app. I'm imagining is what the issue is. You have to be a paid member, not the free member. So I have to look into that a little bit more. It's only, let me get a tissue. It's only $9.99 a month. Less if you buy it by the year. But if you know me, I don't like potions or portions or programs. You know, I don't want anything I'm going to have to pay for that I'm going to have to, like, later on have it for the rest of my life and be paying on something, because I don't feel that life should be restricted in that kind of way. It's bad enough we have utilities and other things. We can't work around no matter what. We just have to have it. There's some slimy stuff here in the egg. I don't know. It don't taste bad, though. Regular eggs, I would have never done that. I just had to taste it. Not bad. So I'm enjoying my coffee. Really enjoying it. And like I said, I see all those little... looks like I put oil in it. And it must have been that cream turned to butter. Which, by the way, heavy whipping cream, if you whip it long enough, it will turn to butter. So you can make your own butter. So, like, I have organic heavy whipping cream. I don't see why I can't make my own cheese, my own butter, you know, anything that I want. But I got to know the calories. I got to know what's going into it. All this processed stuff and whatnot, it's driving me crazy. And I don't think that artificial sweeteners and whatnot, like that's in the gelatin, is helping me. It really isn't. I don't think that I'm losing a significant amount of weight at this stage, you know, having 18 days have passed. I think I've lost about 6 point something or 7, I don't know. Some people would say that's healthy, because if you lose more than 2 pounds a week, that's not healthy. So 8 pounds in a month is healthy. But I'm so used to losing a lot more, just, you know, eating, I wouldn't say necessarily high carb, but I wasn't, like, you know, really, like, counting my carbs. I wasn't worrying about it. I was eating basically the same stuff. You know, I ate tuna. I stayed away from mayonnaise. I stayed away from a lot of dairy, especially cheese. Cheese was not big on my list. Now all of a sudden I'm eating it. Butter, I didn't cook with butter. I cooked with that spray, no-calorie spray butter, which I know they say it's bad for you. But it didn't have all those things that I needed to worry about anyways. So I wasn't eating carbs. Still eating eggs. I wasn't eating bacon. But I was eating chicken and fish. And shrimp. And ground turkey. And every once in a while I would crave a burger. But very rare. Literally very rare, but very rare that I would crave the burger. You know, it was for a long time, that's what I was eating, you know. And so it seemed that maybe my body was in sort of a ketosis state, but it wasn't living or getting its energy off of fat. And probably because I was low carb and low fat, I was losing weight, but I wasn't getting energy because I was tired all the time, guys. I mean, I had a struggle to, you know, get myself out of bed. Excuse me, not fall asleep after a meal. Not be hungry again. Not long after a meal. Just so many different things that I know that this way of living is supposedly better. It's worked for other people. They're doing it. They're living proof that it works. But, you know, I gotta say, without saying any names, that I do love you all who follow me, and I follow you back, and, you know, a few people that I know for a long time from the weight loss community here on YouTube have started, for whatever reason, to catch on to the keto fever. And I don't mean keto flu fever, I mean keto fever, like they found out about keto and they're trying it. And I saw a friend of mine the other day, I won't mention any names, did a shopping haul and started showing all the foods that she bought for herself. that she says keto friendly. So she was like keto friendly shopping haul, or I don't remember if she just said keto haul, keto grocery haul. I don't remember the name of it. But besides all the liquid sweeteners and whatnot, many pork rinds, there was oatmeal. And we're not supposed to eat grains from what I know. That might be paleo, but that sure ain't keto. And Dr. Berg, Eric Berg, sums it up in one particular sentence that he said in one of his videos that I was watching last night about the differences between Atkins and keto. Is Atkins allows for more protein. Now I gotta remember, guys, keto is primarily fat, moderate protein, and very low carb. No more than 20 grams a day of carbs, especially if you're just getting started and you want to go into ketosis quickly. About 75% of your fat, of your calories, come from fat. 20% of your calories are to come from protein, which is going to help sustain hunger as well as the fat. And only about 5% coming from carbs. So if you know what a fat gram is in the way of calories, if you know what a protein gram is in the way of calories, and if you know what a carb gram is in the way of calories, that might help you determine food-wise what you're eating. But being that I come from a place where it took me 40 some odd years, okay? 2011, so I was 41. So it took me 41 years, okay? Not including my younger years when I probably didn't know any better. Anyways, I'm sorry if I keep making noise. I forget that I'm wearing a mic. But in those years, I never learned how to eat. I didn't know how to read labels. I didn't know how to count calories. I didn't know how to weigh out portions. I didn't learn things like to take the chips out of the bag and weigh each individual portion and then maybe put them into separate bags and put that back into the main bag so you're just not blindly eating, because nobody, I don't care who you are, can just count out so many chips while you're eating them. You get kind of lost in the motion, lost in the feeling of, chip, and then you eat all of them. Same with nuts or any other food that comes prepackaged. I didn't know all these things. It took me a little while to learn them as I was inputting my food on Spark People, and I was actually caring enough to watch what I eat and, you know, how much of it I eat. Then it started to kind of, you know, sink in, and I started learning. And that was a whole different way of life that I had learned compared to this, because I didn't eat any fats, and I was staying away from cheese, or I would eat mozzarella with low skim, part skim, whatever mozzarella if I ate cheese, because that was the better cheese. And now I'm hearing, stay away from that. Don't eat the low light, eat the full fat. Different way of eating. Even my mom said to me last night, she says, I can't remember when the last time was when I seen you eat this stuff. I was eating lox, Nova lox, out of the package, taking a slice of cream cheese, putting it in the middle of the piece of lox, and wrapping the lox up and just eating it, like making my own little sushi roll without the rice or anything in there. And my mom, we're Jewish for anybody that didn't know, my mom was looking at me like, you know, and when I say that, it's not a religious thing. It's just like, you know, I say from the inside out, you know, if you grow up eating certain foods, doesn't matter what your beliefs are. I celebrate Christmas, but it doesn't matter what your beliefs are. It's more of a thing like growing up in certain, in a certain lifestyle or tradition, you know, we ate bagels, lox, cream cheese, yada, yada. And so, yeah, you know, here I am eating something and my mom's like, I can't remember the last time I saw you eating that kind of stuff. So here I am eating this kind of stuff. And I've been getting a lot of tummy issues, and I don't know why. I don't know if it's because of what I'm eating. My body's in shock. My body's like, whoa, what the hell are you doing to me? I haven't tasted this in a long time. Haven't felt this in my gut in a long time. I don't know. Or is it something else that I'm lacking? I really don't know, guys. I'd like to say that I had a handle on this thing, and I'm okay, because I was okay in the first couple of days.
first week or so. And then my stomach started hurting. And I get this extreme hunger. At least I think that's what it feels like. I go in the kitchen and I try to eat something that, you know, like a piece of salami. Or I got these little, I think they're like six slices is 110 or 100 something calories. You know, I'm trying to stay, if I am in ketosis, to stay in ketosis. Okay. So with that said, you know, I realized that keto sticks, the ones you pee on and test the color up against the container, I realized that's better than not testing at all. But still, it's not accurate. Dr. Eric Bird says the one way and the greatest way to test is through glucometer. Now, I should have at least one, if not two, glucometers around because my husband, before VSG, for those who don't know, vertical sleeve gastrectomy surgery, weight loss surgery, was type 2 diabetic, and he had at least two of these glucometers. They're really not that expensive. They're even cheaper when you have insurance that can pay for them. But I just looked them up on Amazon, and you can get the whole kit with the lancets to prick your finger, and the strips you need, and all that other stuff. Test your blood sugar. Relatively cheap, like less than $50. Some of them are like $19.99. I don't know if that's just the machine. I saw one for 10 something. So, it's not expensive, guys. I was thinking it was going to be something really expensive. And, you know, of course you want to look at the reviews when you go and buy anything on Amazon. Make sure that they don't mention that they were paid for their review or given the item for free. Some of those I don't really trust. In fact, you know, but I look for some products that a lot of people purchased, and sometimes there's questions that are answered by people who use the stuff, and you can get a pretty good idea if it's, what's better than, you know, might work better, last longer, so on and so forth, and just get one. It isn't going to hurt. If you're serious about doing keto, get one. So that's what my day is going to be today, is I'm going to either buy one or find the one or two that I know that are already lying around the house. I'm going to make sure that the testing strips are the same testing strips used for diabetics, because probably if they're different, then I'm going to have to buy the correct ones. And those are not expensive either. Even the ones that you pee on and test up against with the colors against the container, there are some that are very, very cheap. And there's one that has really good reviews. And it was only like $7 or $12 and change, something like that. And it came with a little holder, container, carry case or something. So, you know, if that was the way that you needed to go because you didn't want the machine or you weren't sure you were going to stick to this keto thing, you know, it can't hurt to have it and keep it. You never know when your insulin levels have risen and your sugar's high. It's always good to know. And now that I care enough to research this stuff and learn what it is I need to learn about it, then obviously I care enough to either find the machine that I know is somewhere here in the house or just purchase one, get it over with, and have it in a couple of days, because I can buy it through a Prime, and my Prime membership, it'll have it here in a couple of days. So that's my next maneuver. I am really serious about this. I kind of feel shitty about how I just scarfed a bunch of crap last night, like out of the blue. It took me back to when I was just eating regular, trying to diet, not able to get a hold on the sugar carb cravings that I was having. And I would do good all day, and then late at night, I would just go in and binge. So I call it a mini binge because it didn't last long. I was able to maintain it and just keep it at what it was. The gelatins were sugar-free, but yes, it's got maltodextrin and all that other crap in there that I don't want to be ingesting because it's probably not good for me on keto. And I really want to try to do this wholeheartedly as it's supposed to be done, because I can't really say that something doesn't work if I'm not working it to the best of my ability, if I'm not doing what is completely suggested that I do. And there's so much misinformation on the internet in some of these groups and whatever and whatnot. And I need to weed out some of them because I'm tired of seeing stuff being posted that I cannot eat and is making me hungry. I mean, literally yesterday, I had just gotten into a new keto group that Michelle Rocks here on YouTube
suggested as one of the better groups that she goes to. And I don't know the name of it off the top of my head. It's no surprise probably to any of you who watch me. But, yeah, got into that group right after being approved. And the first few posts were